The next exercise is you would use two sticky notes. Now, again, depending on how you feel with the X's, like I'm not a big fan of them right now, or the two dots. So right now, again, because I can't use the X's, I would use two dots. So you're standing about shoulder length away, and the targets are approximately 1.5 to 2 feet apart from each other. So, and again, at eye level. Now this one is tends to be less dizzy provoking. This one is more about training the VOR and separating this head and eye motion. So it's typically a little bit longer exercise as you get better. So can be up to 2 minutes depending on how you tolerate. Typically, not really dizzy provoking, but it can be a challenge to the vestibular ocular reflex. So you may feel a little bit uncoordinated when you start at first. So again, sticky notes a little bit farther apart. You want to be able to see them clearly, so you should easily be able to see both targets as you move your eyes side to side a little bit. So you'll start with pointing your nose and your eyes at the target on the left. Then you will move your eyes to the target on the right and then your head. So your eyes are always leading this motion. So your eyes will move back and forth. It doesn't need to be quick, but it needs to be a separated motion. So your eyes always move first and then your head as you go back and forth. Now this one, up to 2 minutes, but if it starts to make you dizzy, then you want to go ahead and stop and take a break and let your symptoms come down. Same thing you will do with up and down. So the targets a little bit further apart on the wall, you're standing arm's length, a little bit more than arm's length away. You start looking up at the target higher, move your eyes down, and then your head. Eyes up, head up. Eyes down, head down. So you're separating those two motions. Again, you can do up to 2 minutes. So that's typically referred to as X to Y viewing. You don't have to use an X and a Y. I use the dots, like I said. So that would be, again, another one for the VOR. Another exercise you can do is, it's called times two viewing. It's another gaze stabilization, but it's a little bit more complicated because the target is not staying stationary. This is not something you should start with. Usually by week two or week three, people can introduce it unless they're still having symptoms from basically the stable target. So you can use your thumb to do this. The shoulder can get a little tired because now this is a moving target. It's okay to switch arms. It's okay to not go for a full minute, especially if you're symptomatic. But you're holding your thumb out in front of you. You're looking at your nail. Now your thumb's gonna be moving side to side slightly. You're not doing a lot of motion. The most common mistake with this one is that people crank their arm side to side. When you combine that with head motion, it typically makes people very symptomatic. So as you're holding your thumb out, it's gonna go side to side a little bit and your eyes are gonna stay on your thumbnail. Now as that's happening, your head is going to turn opposite your thumb. And you can see I'm not cranking my neck, I'm not doing a lot of thumb motion. It's very small movements. Keeping your eyes on your thumbnail, you're just going from side to side. You can also, as you get better, the speed can increase with this one. But as you start, the most important thing is being able to keep your eyes on your thumbnail without seeing double vision, without it really blurring, and without it jumping around, okay? So that's times two viewing side to side. It would look a little bit different going up and down. So my nose is pointed down, my thumb is up, and as my thumb moves down, my head's going to move up, but my eyes are still staying on my thumbnail. So I'm moving my arm a little bit, not over cranking. You can use either arm, you can switch. If your arm gets tired, that's fine. But you would work towards that one for a minute. If you need to take a break, if you can only do 10 seconds, you start with 10 seconds and you work with that. So those are some basic standing exercises you can do. Some other, not easy ones, I don't want to say that, but some other basic exercises that you can start with is just eye tracking. So you can stand, again, shoulder width apart, you can stand narrow, and you can do side to side motions, up and down motions with just your eyes. So if I'm standing here, I'm moving my eyes to the left and I'm scanning to the right. Sorry, you want to keep your head still. I moved mine a little bit there. So just side to side tracking. You can stand certain distances. Oh, you can stand at plain backgrounds. You can stand a little bit more busy backgrounds, which will feel a little bit harder. You probably want to start with more basic. You can also do the same thing up and down. So moving your eyes up and down, you just want to make sure that you don't feel too off balance with this. If you do, you can stand next to a counter. You can stand with your feet a little wider apart. Just be safe about that one too. So those are some basics. The next thing that you can do to make these a little bit harder is implement those same exercises with walking. As you introduce walking, again, safety is the most important thing. So I usually tell patients, you want to start at a counter as you start to step. So don't just stand out in your hallway or in an open space and start walking and introduce head movement. It's not a good idea if you don't know how your balance is going to respond. So I'm going to back up here a little bit. As you're walking, you actually want to walk at a slow pace. You don't want to walk too fast, which is the tendency with these exercises. As you slow down, it actually forces your balance system to work harder, which I know seems opposite, but slower is better. You certainly don't have to snail pace it by any means, but if you slow down and really focus on the steps that you're taking and combine that with head motion, you will train both your vestibular system as well as your proprioceptive system. So I just showed you side to side. I'm not walking a far distance. You probably want to walk a little further than this, but I don't want to get too far because I want you to be able to see me. But up and down, keeping your eyes on a target, walking slowly towards the object. You want to keep things where it's not jumping too much, not double vision, and give yourself the best shot at being able to see the target too. So if the dot behind me, if something like that's too small, use something that's a little bit bigger. The last thing I want to talk about on this video is scanning. So scanning tends to be a little bit more of a habituation exercise versus VOR, but it can be a very functional exercise for gaining some of that stability back and decreasing the brain's response to motion. So what that means is scanning takes away that focus on the target. So if I'm doing scanning, my head and my eyes are actually going together. So I'm looking from side to side, I'm scanning everything, I'm trying to not let my eyes skip a big amount of space, but side to side. Now again, you can stand as if you're feeling unstable with your feet shoulder width apart. As it gets easier, move your feet closer together. As that gets easier, you can introduce walking with it. Again, walking should be slow. You should start next to a counter for safety, and you can also do up and down. So up and down, which can be a little bit more dicey because up and down is going to stimulate more of the posterior canal and the superior canal. So you may find that looking down in particular tends to be more aggravating, but looking up typically isn't much fun either because of the way that, first of all, the canals are activated, and secondly, because of the cervical spine. So up and down, scanning, looking up towards the ceiling, and looking down towards the floor. I usually tell patients to avoid maximal cervical extension because it tears up the neck and can make you stiff and sore and just add to other issues, so be careful with that. So those are some basic VOR exercises that you can start with. Again, I'm going to send Pam and Karen some documents that follow more of a 6-week program. It walks through some basic progressions, things like that, that you can do. The only other thing I would add to this is beware of your posture, like we've talked about, and then if your neck starts to get sore, because this is a lot of movement that's being introduced to the cervical spine, if your neck gets really sore, make sure that you're staying on top of it. I will post some exercises too and stretches for the neck if that's helpful, but you want to use ice on your neck. So if your neck's starting to feel a little stiff and a little achy from it, then don't be afraid to use some ice around the neck to help settle things down, and that should help.